You are in the morning, you know, sippy, cheery, bubbling. Always see the students now. You should have learned that in the morning be very energetic, so the student can take modeling from you. That all the time when you are, you know, in the morning, you should be very, very cheerful and bubbling with energy, so they can, you know, always remember, yes, our teacher has taught at least one thing, that in the morning, if you spend full energy for, say, 3-4 hours, the whole day become very fruitful. I'm grateful to Venchen, who has come to my office and talk about it, that they like to have something on adults, and then we discuss about it. And because I'm the joint secretary of Indian Association of Adults and Health, and we are promoting the schools to adopt the school health program, and then we discuss about it. We are grateful that we are having Wing Commander R.K. Mandal. He is the BGS World School in Bangalore, who has taken up this school health program, and we have got good results. So I'll present those all findings. All of you are now heading the schools, all principals and council members, and you know, many people are there who are directly, indirectly linked with the administration of the school. In spite of, I can say that we have, we'll discuss about that, how much percentage you are handling. Our children are not coming with the, you know, some innovation, something which can lead the world. Why this is happening? So today, if we can discuss about it, it's a serious knot in the morning, that how we can make our adolescent vibrant. With us, we have a panel, and the panel has been divided according to the need, the psychological component, the nutrition, the cyber crime, and then security. These are all integral part. You all know what is health, and if health is not there, your school is not there. It's very simple. If the child is not healthy, he will not come to school, and you cannot run the school. If they are healthy, that is where they are coming. And there, you have to promote it. And that is the concept today. We have to discuss that how school can become promoting the health. And so it becomes vibrant all the time. And the society can become vibrant out of it. So my presentation would be, can we start the presentation? Yeah. So necessity of launching school health program in schools. That's the what I want. But your logo is for healthy classroom and healthy mind. So how we can match these two things? Now if you see the statistics, simple statistics, it says the 1.2 billion population is in this age group of adolescents. And India also itself, it's 20% of the population belongs to this age. And that is 10 to 19 years. And that time when the child is coming to schools. Now this is the power. I say this is the group which is going to make you your future. How you can, you know, play with, lightly, with your future. That's a question today in the morning we should ask. They're going to decide who should be leading our country. It is the political power which is going to be there. So you can't, you know, leave them that, okay, whatever you do. We have to groom them in that manner that they become the powerful, you know, population. Now you see that this one is, if we include the youth also, it is almost now 35 to 40% of the population. It's a huge, big population. And that is why we are concerned about it. You know, we have to have something for them. If we see the enrollment, we'll just see that how much enrollment we have. Very close. Okay. In the first year, you know, when they come to you, it is 100% enrollment ratio. And then slowly it goes down. Why? That's a question. ever be asked about this, that why they are. But the, my question is not this one. My question is that this huge population is actually remained with you at least for 6 to 7 hours. And that is a very fruitful time when you can handle them in a manner which can make the future. Now this is the number of institutions which you already must be knowing it. Now why we should focus on school? I already said focus because the children are getting things or suffering from the statistic which is shown here. You can see the number one cause of death in adolescent is road traffic injuries. Second is HIV and AIDS. Third is self-harm. Fourth is lower respiratory tract infections, interpersonal violence, diarrhea, these all things. So the communicable is not there. Communicable infections and disease are almost now gone in most of our schools, except some of the schools which are there in our rural setup. But mainly it is of road traffic and self-harm which is causing. When it is assessed in terms of global burden of disease, you know, when we adjust the disability adjusted life year, then number one comes to be unipolar depression. And that is why, you know, every school principals and teacher must be aware of that, what is depression, how we can find out the depression. Next is road traffic accidents. Iron deficiency anemia, which should have not been there. You know, that is why the nutrition expert is here. We'll discuss about it, that in spite of coming from the very affluent family, you know, they are suffering from, you know, malnutrition. They are suffering from micronutrients. There are so many nutrients. They are not to that level which they can become the athletes. They can become something great in the Olympics and other games. So these are all 10 leading cause of daily loss, disability adjusted life year loss. Now, see, the child mind or say adolescent mind is a very interesting mind. And most of us must understand, those who have come from psychology understand that this mind is different from, you know, others. You see that some of the lobes are growing and are developing things. So these lobes must be understood by all the people who are dealing with these adolescents. The issue is that, you know, the synapses which are there in the brain keep increasing in number. You know, it is not up to the age of 2 or 3. They continue to grow, and going up to age of 20, you can see the gray matter is increasing, you know, and it's reached to, you know, highest grade. And now the concept is that brain continue to grow, even develop, even, you know, modify in the age, late age, like 40 or 50. And we have studies showing that that is where the new concept has come, the neuroplasticity. You know, you can train the mind in a particular skills later on also. So it is not that certain period of time they are no more changing. And the crucial point is that all the time they are increasing in the activities and they can learn a lot of skills. The most important part is here that, you know, if you neglect the child because of whatever reason, the size of the brain is less, you know, and that is why we have to make him all the time active, you know, and provide a supportive environment. That's make the full active brain. Now this is to be understood by all of us, that why the people are behaving, or the adolescent are behaving in a particular manner. This is the development. If the red line you can see, it is actually a limbic system which is dealing with emotions and, you know, rewards. And the green line is prefrontal cortex that is leading, or that is, you know, for the planning and logic. So what happens? These people are, you know, taking, they are very emotional. That is why they do certain things, and that you can correlate with. That is why we have the depression, we have the road traffic accidents, because they indulge in certain activity which is emotional in nature, and they are not able to correlate with the logic and planning. You know, that is why they are weak in planning. So at the same time, you know, you can see that the person is emotionally charged but not able to understand the effect of it. So it is nothing to do with that child. It is something related to brain. To be with it, that's the question. And that is why we have so many issues during this period. You can see, you know, that depression is more, substance abuse is more, you know, and just and self-harm is also very common. So they fall in love and they are not able to understand what is the repercussion of it. They will indulge in sex, they will indulge in, you know, alcohol intake, but not able to understand the, what is the meaning of it. And that's the problem with this. So one has to deal with it. Be careful that this is the natural phenomena of it. Now this is again a, you know, a slide showing that this is the time when maximum number of, you know, adolescents are getting drugs, you know, alcohol, tobacco, the maximum. And it will continue. If they are indulged in it, they will continue to have in late in their life. So you can see that most of the things which are there starting in school, whether it is a physical activity or inactivity, alcohol, tobacco, or maybe type of food they start taking, you know, you can see that one, all are in later life, continue to suffer, continue to have that. And the one example is 18% of adolescents who use tobacco continue to have this smoking, 50% of them, and then 7% of that and 30% of non-communicable disease will be there in their adult life. You can see that all, you know, is leading to, whether it is overweight or antisocial personality or all kinds of alcohol-related deaths, inactivity. So the child, when they learn how to be inactive, will continue to have inactive life throughout and then leading to so many type of problems later on. And that is why I say that actually 70% of all your disease which you see also in you, you yourself can imagine, it was actually started at the school. That is why we have to talk about school. That is why we have to talk about when they are young. So we have to catch them young. Then only we can prevent future. So please tell them that this is the future which you are going to create. Now read it. I think most of you must have read it. But I say, who has written it? It states, the children now love luxury, they have bad manners, contempt to authority, they allow disrespect to elder, love gender in the place of exercise. Children now are tyrant, not the servant of their household. They no longer rise when elders enter the room. They contradict their parents, shatter before company, gamble with dandy at the table, cross their legs, and who has written? Anybody? And that is the, you know, sign that how much we read the history. Huh? Yes. Yes, great. It is Socrates. So that should solve all the issues. It's nothing new. We should make, should not make these, you know, children and adults and, you know, terrorists or all the time bad, doing something wrong. It's the nature. It was there. It is there. It is going to be there. We have to learn how to deal with it. When we know the knowledge, I think we can do a lot of things. That is why, you know, this is another study. Most of the children are not like this. It is all, just you can say, you know, that is 23%. And surgeon, which is doing a lot of work and very active, rising, that is 35%. And otherwise, you know, one third of the children are going to be silently passing that phase. So don't make every adolescent is, you know, terrorist. That is why the government has started this Kishore Swasth Karyakram, that is National Adolescent Health Program. We are part of it. They have identified, although it is started very late, 2014, 7th January. But the issue is that these are the major, you know, priority areas of the government. And the school has to identify that we have to, you know, pick up all these priority areas to make our adolescent very strong. That nutrition, sex and reproductive health, conditions of the non-communicable diseases, substance abuse, injury and violence, and mental health. If we can handle these all, I think we can make the adolescent very, very healthy. Now, these are all interventions. These are the priority areas, but how you are going to achieve it? The achievement can be community-based interventions. You know, that's the most important. And I'll tell you that how the school can play a role in community-based interventions. You know, one is a peer education for non-communicable disease, communicable disease, substance abuse, and mental health. Then quarterly, adolescent health day should be celebrated, where the screening can be done for various diseases. The weekly iron folic acid, you know, program is already running. Most of the school must be giving it. Then we have the menstrual hygiene scheme is already, you know, placed, and most of the school must be doing it. Then we have the facility-based intervention like the adolescent-friendly health clinic. Unfortunately, in most of the, you know, health centers, we are having this clinic, but students are not coming. We understand that why they are not coming, and this is actually the failure of our, you know, system, how to make the clinic friendly so the student can come. The convergence is also required. It is not the job of only health and family welfare, but the education and, you know, youth affair and other the mother and child welfare ministry has to come forward to adopt these all things, then only it's possible. Advocacy is another one. The BCC and, you know, IPC, all these communication has to be learned by our school teacher who are dealing with the children. And then NGOs and professional body has to work to achieve those objectives. Now, just want to say that how we have achieved in BGS World School. The principal has accepted this concept. They said, okay, I want to run this school health program. Rather, it's health which is promoting by this school. So a school promoting the health, that should be there. So what is started that, you know, first the school become the member of our Indian Association of Adults and Health. We launched this program in 2015. After that, you know, general well-being checkup was done of all students by us. Then we have screen for their health. The health screening was done of all students in a comprehensive manner by using the questionnaire and other parameters. Then we have the general annual medical checkup of all students conducted on the health issue, particularly the mental health. It was, you know, having the medical history, mental checkup, questionnaire, physical health was all given. Then we conducted the health awareness workshop for students and staff, which again is a very systematic manner was done. Then after that, we have launched a program on a community health survey. So we made the groups which are going to the community under supervision of the teacher. And then it was an 8 weeks exercise gathering the data from, you know, the community nearby when they are living somewhere, if they have to go to the village, that they have to collect the data on their parameters like the socioeconomic status and health issues. If in any family somebody suffering from tuberculosis or, you know, hepatitis or maybe diabetes or hypertension, they have to ask, say that, are you taking the drugs or not? Why you are not taking, why not you go to the school, to the doctors? So what the thing is observed, and then qualitative assessment of the student was done, and it was the learning of the student which was the most important part. They learn about the disease, they connect to the community, they understood the whole milieu of the structure of the, you know, families and also the society, which is our achievement. That a student is now perceiving, you know, the need of the community, where they can themselves change and also become that, you know, agent of change to the community. That is the objective of this program, which was very well done. Then we have the annual checkup of the staff member. When we say the school health, it cannot be achieved by the, you know, dividing the staff of whole school. Then this girl got the, you know, gold medal for the community health activities in the school. So she got the national award on the social work services. We have, you know, 13 teachers who have now come forward. It was started in a very small scale, but now the all teachers were, you know, excited to take up this. And then now they are going to cover 1,200, you know, houses. You can see that how many families can be covered and population can be covered by the student to educate the, you know, community members. So because of that, you know, we have very good achievement. At the same time, we are looking after the staff. The health, you know, survey of the staff was done. And this is possible. You know, it is not that the school cannot do. You know, one has to go out, talk to the nearby hospital, nursing home, and the doctors will come forward to help you. It is not that they are not. You have to discuss the issue. They will definitely do free of cost event. You know, it has been done. You have to develop the convergence and then see who can be do, can be you know, capped. And then the achievement has been highlighted in newspaper also. edition of Times of India was, you know, publishing how the school is doing well. Then the efforts yield to 10, you know, research paper published by this time. And then, you know, it has become vibrant school. So I can see the change because I'm following you for 3 years. So definitely these are all publications which is out of that, you know. And this Blue Whale Challenge is recently, you must have heard about it. The publication is very well published in various. This is a module on the managing stress in adolescent. And our organization has a website. Anybody can become a member as an institution and individual also. You all can be party to, you know, the change which we want in the country and the world. You know, it's possible. We are running the journal also, and we are holding very workshops. We have various kind of workshop. It can be using only the models. We can use only the student developing the models and teaching themselves. We can have the skill-based, you know, exercise, role play. These all things we are doing in different and publishing documents. This is national conference, and then different areas we are doing it. Publication at the news is also quite well accepted. We do the health camp, school health camps, the community health camp. Our medical students love to go to the school and deliver their whatever they know. So all possible. You can, you know, generate the momentum. This is in the Goa, which we have done. This is the medical college where the first year students who are just 18 and 17, you know, they are taught about this. These are all different branches are doing in different, like the Gujarat, we have the Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. The many places we are doing various kind of activities. So I'll tell you that, you know, if one school start, the other will definitely follow it. And in one day, if all can become the health promoting school, and we are in a process that how we can develop the criteria that your school can be labeled as health promoting school, you know, then it's possible. I'll tell you that it's not only just a student, but the workers, you know, the teachers, the employee, other employee has to be healthy. Then only the, you know, school can become the vibrant and the healthy. So that is what I wanted to convey, and, you know, thank you very much.